I'm inspired by all the people that I meet in all of the moments and everything that really surrounds us and all the energy, all the vibes that you just get from everybody. And just transporting that to art, I think it's the most pure thing that you can have.
Inspire me is losing control in order to find some high state of mind and soul. Lose control sometimes is good if you are in a safe environment.
Our passion is just the work we do, like trying to get better at what we do and get our music to everywhere, everyone, and make people feel what we feel or we think we feel.
I feel really empowered. My mind is bubbling with ideas. I just want to talk to everyone and know everyone. That's the whole point of this festival, to give a voice to people that are not that famous or not that known.
Kind of opens up my mind of what is actually possible and what could happen if you put your mind to it.
What excites me in this event, it's a great opportunity not only to promote my work, but to embrace this generation of artists.
Coming here to dance and see the creative people, it's kind of really better than being stuck in an office. But this is kind of a way for me to be free.
We're here in Lisbon 2017 to carry out the second edition of the Young Minds Matter Festival. We connected different artists from all around Europe together to create projects on issues that were current to them.
It's really interesting and exciting and inspiring to connect with another person who are really engaging and they really know what they want to do in life. And at the same time, it's really interesting and inspiring to speak to people that is still not sure where they're going, but at the same time, they have the courage to explore. When you're young, there's this kind of like raw creativity that as you get older, a lot of people tend to lose that. So it's really interesting to reconnect with this energy. So that's why just being here, just being in Lisbon, is inspiring for me.
Most of all, it's a community of friends because you come here and you don't know anybody, but in 2 or 3 minutes, everyone's talking to you, everyone's smiling, everyone's having a good time, everyone's sharing ideas and sharing dreams and what they want to do in the future.
So right now we're in Año 70, Portugal, Lisbon. Elevate Your Minds 2017. It's a nice space, this.
What brings me to Lisbon? Well, I'm here with Elevate Your Minds and I'm just here to collaborate with some international artists and get to meet some new people and also see the city of Lisbon. I've never been here before, so it's just about, you know, creating memories.
I wanted to come to Lisbon because I'm always shy and I always say no to things that I'm not used to, but I thought that now was the time to like open my eyes a bit more. You don't normally get things like this in England, like all being in one place, like everyone is diving off each other, like everybody's chatting. It's just really nice to get to know different people. I feel a bit more confident as well going up to different people. Even though they speak a different language, I don't think it's a barrier.
Vibe is ridiculous. You'll turn up and people will be doing things. There'll be a sound check with a band playing and then you'll come outside, somebody will be painting. And everybody's just having a good time and doing what they enjoy and creating things that they're passionate about.
Part of the reason we wanted to bring together different backgrounds was to have a festival that had a variety of disciplines. A day in the festival will be a variety of artistic disciplines, which is amazing to see. And it doesn't really matter on the quality level, as long as you're passionate, you see the vision, and you're really willing to develop with us. And I do really believe that everyone that gets involved with this type of programs will end up making a load of friends that will never leave their life, because you will always be connected somehow because of the experience you've shared intensively throughout this period.
I see a lot of artists that are doing their wonderful artworks on home, and they are young and their parents pay their stuff and they have an amazing inner world and they don't just have the vibe to go and just show the world. That's why I think it's important to push artists to show their stuff in order to develop their work and to learn with other artists.
And that's one of our main aims, to connect emerging artists with professionals in the industries, and that's exactly what we're doing.
It's very nice to have positive reactions, actually. It's nice to to show your stuff, because I don't usually show my stuff to strangers that much. So I think I'm learning to do that. And I participated last year and I enjoyed it a lot. And I'm very happy that it grew so much this year and it's being really awesome.
Last year it was just a one-day festival. This year it's been a three-day festival that's been very energetic.
This actually goes right back to when Elevate Your Mind started. Eddie got to know a few people who were at his uni at the time, Ines and Beatrice, and they're both from Lisbon. They got involved with Elevate Your Mind, showcasing their artwork at projects and events. And they were like, why don't we just take an event out to Lisbon? We took it out last year, worked pretty well. So we're back this year to run the event. We've got a few more projects this year.
The Young Minds Matter Elect started from an interest from friends of mine, Ines Brito and Beatrice Bagulu, who were at the time studying at Leeds College of Arts. And we connected because they were involved in our first exhibition. And from there, they wanted to replicate it in Lisbon. So we decided to take it to Lisbon. And because of their support network in Lisbon, we were able to really develop the project, develop what we wanted to do.
We are always learning with this kind of event because we talk with several people and all people have something to teach us. It's an excellent experiment for our lives.
I have learned a lot of things, not necessarily from the musicians, but because of them. Like working with them, you learn from that yourself, you know? Yesterday I got to work with a harp player, and that's something that you don't get to do every day, so that was really interesting. And I learned a lot from her because of working with her.
I am hoping to relax and have a good time, but I'm also hoping to meet more artists who inspire me, who maybe do a particular thing that I don't know about or wouldn't consider being art or being relevant to me.
I have a lot of emotions inside, and mostly while painting, it's like art therapy for me. So I transfer my emotions through the art. So this time I wanted to show it like in front of the camera. I met amazing people and I really hope we can collaborate in the future to make some art projects.
So with the artist collaborations, it was a really interesting process to see, for myself especially. For a lot of it, I got to take a step back and watch everybody else create their pieces. So I was seeing discussions where people are talking about what they're passionate about, the things that drive them to create their art, what their art means to them, and seeing how these ideas come together between these two artists who've like never met before. They've only ever spoken online up until the Tuesday when we first met. It was crazy to see the response from it and see that all that's needed is a bit more confidence. And if you create something that means something, people love it. They'd like to see emotion and rawness and something that actually means something to somebody.
So being surrounded by creatives from different practices really energized and humbled me, because there's so many great and creative ideas, and there were really powerful pieces in the festival that really connects with feelings inside of me. I was like, wow, that gave me the shivers, that gave me like, it's really hard to explain.
That's the beauty of it. It was given a lot of liberty for people to do whatever they want, and it's not common to just happen or exist an event like this that has so much different things going on at the same time, but at the same point they combine really well together in this space.
It's so much bigger in all the ways, you know. It's more freshy, it's more peaceful.
The festival is only successful if the community that we deliver this program at receives and sees the vision in what we're trying to do. We worked to develop the program based on what we felt young artists in this economical climate needed, which was simply to come together.
Collaborative, creative events that connect up UK and Europe is super important, because it goes in the idea of mindset and perception. One perception of people from the UK, so what do people think of people from the UK? And then at the same time, what do we people from the UK think about people in Europe? So I guess events like this helps to break down the preconceived connotations and get people to really connect to other human beings for what they are and their interests and their passions. And also restore the belief that there are a lot of good people in life still. Even though the media don't tell you that.
Not only Brexit, we have like a lot of idealistic walls or metaphysical walls that human beings want to build that separate us from each other in order to protect our inner selves. We need to destroy that walls and come together because we are one.
Especially because we're the new generation, right? We're gonna be the ones taking the decisions from now on. I think it's important that we get to see what's happening in other countries and that we understand that we can do so much more by coming together, because this wouldn't have been possible with just Portuguese people or with just English people. Bringing people together, it's very important so that we realize that we need to keep this. This is important, this is precious, we need to cherish it. The more we do it, the better. Brexit is something that we need to understand shouldn't have happened.
How are people in the UK dealing with that? How are younger people dealing with that? And how does it affect their lives and our lives? So it's important to maintain this bridge, because art is all about that. It's about keeping people together. This is the most important thing at this event, is keeping people together, even if everyone else wants to make us as far apart as possible.
Whatever happens, it's not because you're from the UK that you're not European anymore. And even if that were the case, does it really matter where you're from? At least for me, it kind of doesn't. I mean, everybody speaks English, everybody gets along. Even if you don't speak English, you can like make yourself understand. People dance with each other they have never met before, people play with each other. I mean, that's Brexit. Fuck that.
Isto é texto sobre nada e sobre tudo. Peca pela falha, pela forma e eu desisto. Quando se fala, fala sobre nada, que apaga o vazio. Sobre a alma tem de sobra, a diferença entre arte e obra. Estilo e moda, a arte à morda, artista engorda, para a sorte. Arma torta, malhado não acerta em ninguém. Peca pela falha, pela forma e eu desisto.
A festival of this scale does not come together overnight. I would probably say we've been working on this for a year. After the festival is over, we'll go back to the drawing board and look at what we learn, how to move forward.
Just come. You are losing everything if you're not coming.
I mean, don't miss it. Just check. If you couldn't make it this year, check all the videos, all the footage. Check this. Don't listen to me because I never say anything useful, but check everybody else and you'll understand that this was amazing, and you had everything to just have the best weekend of your life. And don't lose it next year, don't miss it, it's gonna be probably even better.
I can tell you, when I was coming here today, I've been dancing and smiling, and I feel pretty great to be here, and I wish this event happened more often, because in an artistic way it's so healthy to be here. I would say to people to come with open minds, because what we are going to see in this event, it's not from a conceptual gallery or a famous museum. It's just a bunch of kids who are trying to be artists in their lives and are experimenting a lot of things. So come here to enjoy new things and have the opportunity to know the young minds who are going to be great in the future.
With this festival, I always surprise myself about how successful it is and how much you gain and how many people you talk to, how many people you learn from, and the kind of quality conversations you have out here, and the work, you know, it's just so inspiring. There's so much going on, and I hope a lot more people will be coming next year from the UK, from everywhere else.
Just be happy and follow your passion, whatever it is. If it is like killing people or killing little babies, don't do it. It's my advice.